waiting for your UFC debut. Finally happened. You did it in a style. How do you feel about your first fight in the octagon?
Yeah, you know, it couldn't went any better. To be able to get a first round finish, I feel on top of the world, and to be able to make an entrance like that into the UFC, I feel fantastic about the situation. And obviously, like I say, in the UFC like that, for me, couldn't went any better.
Talk about the finish for a minute. I mean, he went limp. Did you feel him tap at all, or what do you think was going on?
Do you know what? I was concentrating on really putting that squeeze on, and obviously just really trying to get that finish. I seen that he was a little bit exposed, and like I said, I've been working in the gym and getting scrambles, getting up, turning back to my feet, become a lot more dynamic, my striking more than him, moving all the rest of the teammates, which is my black symbol. So, yeah, for me, trying to get up, I was going to do it, but then I seen the opportunity to be able to just flip my leg over, go in the triangle, try to straighten out the arm, go through the arm bar at the same time, and like I say, strong hips, strong legs, put the squeeze on, and quick enough, you're going to sleep.
A lot of buzz about you. A lot of people, you know, within the MMA community, very excited about you. Did you pay attention to that? And did you feel like, all right, I really got to step up here?
No, more so than I think it's kind of it's humbling and it's more heartfelt because the journey that I've took has been a long road. I'm somebody who came from nothing. I'm somebody who wasn't really meant to be at the top or meant to be able to see rising. So for me, it was more sort of on a personal level. It was like heartfelt, and to be able to see the response I have from people really kind of got me in the mood, got me motivated to get out of there, and to be able to give people what they want to see and put on a show.
When did you feel like this is actually something that you see from a tough background? This is actually something that is attainable. This is an impossible dream as opposed to an impossible dream. When did you actually feel that?
I've actually felt that. Like I said, I proved to myself. I fight demons myself. I'm always fighting against myself, not against the opponent outside of the ring. So caged, glamour. So obviously, for me to be able to go out there and fight by fight, I'm always proving myself that I'm doing it the right way, and like I say, I'm stepping towards that dream, and I'm looking to others that it can be done, no matter where you come from, what your upbringing is, or what your history or your past is. It can be done with a lot of hard work, dedication, motivation, and belief. Self-belief is the biggest thing that anyone can have. And don't let anyone ever tell you that you can't do it. So I live by them rules, and I'm here to prove to everyone that you can be done.
So it's been, you know, a long time coming, and you know, the last time you fought before this was like over a year ago. Now you've been here doing, you know, media stuff. At what point did you really feel like, okay, I'm a UFC fighter, this is actually happening, this isn't a dream?
It's kind of been, like I say, as I've been going for my career, and I've been getting the performances that I want, and bit by bit I've been chipping away at sort of the skill level, and I'm extending my assets as far as martial arts go. I've really, like I say, been proving to myself that it can be done. So, like I say, I'll say the last few fights, the performances that I've got, I've realised that I belong at the top with some of the best in the world, and I've got all the attributes to be able to put it across performance-wise, level-wise. I just really want to be able to show the world that I'm there to shine and put performances and entertain people, and as well be able to make something for the future for myself and my family. So, my baby hasn't got to go through what I went through, but I really want to be able to turn things around and make him a cry kid.
When you say demons, what do you mean by that?
When I say demons, I just mean like from an upbringing that I had, things were hard, and I never really got to be able to. I got the advantage and things like that, so I was always fighting against myself to be able to push myself to the limit. And like I say, I'm one of those people that wasn't supposed to make it. As a child, growing up, things were hard. Things were very hard to attain. I had to work hard for it. Every single thing I've done, from every step I took in life, to go through school, right up until now, it still goes on. And now I'm in the UFC, I can finally make something for myself and my family. So, yeah, I say them demons, and that, I mean them demons for me, is just proving that I've got what it takes to be able to change my life, my future, my family's future, and that's what I'm looking for.
So what do you do now? I mean, you come away with those days. Are you ready to get back in the gym, or do you take a little bit of time off? What's next?
Well, this is the thing. I've been down at the Black Indians now in Boca Raton. Big thank you to my team, all the supporters, all my coaches, in Florida, for the job they've done with me. I've been there for 6 months now, I've been working real hard. So, yeah, I'm going to go home. I've just had a little baby boy as well, so I'm going to spend a little bit of quality time. I've been home for 3 months now. I've only seen him for a week. So it's going to be nice to be able to go home, have some cuddles. I'm fresh. So I'm hoping that the UFC, Dana, get me a fight, get me back out there. You've got UFC London coming up, and you might get that card. You know, being a big fan base back at home, I love the support I've got from them, it's been phenomenal. So we're going to get loads of people there, you know what I mean? So, yeah, I want to continue. fresh. Like I said, I had a little bit of a break since my last fight with Cage Warriors and stuff like that, so let's keep it going.
As a lover of hot chocolate, your name, your nickname is one of the very best. Where does it come from?
Oh, it's crazy how I got that. To be fair, I moved from London to another place up in the northwest, Liverpool. At the time, I was working security and my boss actually just called me Hot Chocolate. So I had no chance. At the time, no one knew me, so I got introduced to the city as Hot Chocolate. It stuck by me and it's been with me for 6 years. And yeah, like I say, it's catchy. Everyone kind of likes it or loves it. Hot chocolate's not a bad taste of food, so you know, England's going to be that.
And you've had some pretty, you know, exciting finishes before. How high do you rank this finish off, you know, on the scale of best fights?
To be fair, I kind of surprised myself with the finish that I had. I wasn't necessarily looking for submission. Like I said, my striking's become a lot more dynamic. Power's gone through the roof. I was kind of looking to put him away, and I thought I was going to put him away as well. Get that knockout bonus, but Dana's feeling good. He wants to give a submission bonus, a performance bonus. Then I'm happy to take that at the same time as well. But yeah, as far as performances go, finishes are finishes. That's what entertains people. That's what makes me feel good. So I just want to continue finishing people and proving that it needs to be someone that you need to watch out for me.
Congrats.